Deputy Donnelly, please. Thank you. Thank you, Deputy Higgins. Unfortunately, I didn't call you. I called Deputy Donnelly. Thank you. Now, Deputy Donnelly, when you're ready, please. Thank you.
Minister, last week, thousands of nationwide mortgages were sold to two US debt firms, Lone Star and Oaktree. Now, we're told the firms bought the mortgages in arrears, so presumably that's where they believe they'll get most of their profits. It's from the families whose mortgages are in arrears. Now, we don't know what discount the loans were sold at, but there's a lot of things we do know. We do know that sales of this type around the world typically attract about a 70% discount. So a mortgage of 250,000 will have been sold on for about 75,000. We know the special liquidator didn't ask Oaktree or Lone Star for a binding commitment on adhering to the CCMA, and we know there isn't going to be any oversight of their voluntary commitment. We know the families weren't allowed to bid on their own mortgages. We know you cited a PwC report for this. Now, you refused to release the PwC report to the Dáil, but we have since got a copy of it from the special liquidator, and we know that you have stated that neither you nor any of your officials have yet seen this report or have access to it. The end of the report, Minister, is quite interesting in that it shows the criteria used to disallow the families from bidding for their own mortgages. And what we know from those criteria is that the welfare of these tens of thousands of men, women and children was explicitly excluded from any consideration. And worse than that, Minister, we know that when I asked this government if it would pause the sales process to see if we could find a process that allowed the families to bid and returned the same or more money to the state, the answer from this government was no. In short, this government has sold these men, women and children down the river. Now, I've met with some of the families whose mortgages have just been sold to Lone Star and Oaktree. These are people who could have refinanced their mortgages at whatever discount has been given to these US debt firms, but now won't, many of whom will end up being evicted. So my question, Minister, is this. What do you say to these tens of thousands of men, women and children? What do you say to a family whose mortgage of 250,000 has just been sold to a US debt specialist for 75,000? How do you explain to them that their interests were in no way considered in deciding not to let them bid on their own mortgages?
Thank you. Minister.
IBRC was liquidated by a special liquidator who was empowered to do so by a special legislation that was brought through the Houses of the Oireachtas. And the liquidator acted in accordance with that piece of legislation. And his primary mandate was to realise the best possible price for the assets he was disposing in the interests of the state and in the interests of the Irish taxpayer. And in that context, he made a decision to sell loan books rather than individual loans. And that's the advice he got, I understand, from the document that you have referred to. And in doing so, he succeeded in having a very successful sale from the liquidator's perspective. He didn't infringe on the rights of any mortgage holder. They haven't been disadvantaged in any way by the transfer of their loans to a different owner. And he also got assurances from both Lone Star and Oaktree that the protocols that have been put in place by the central bank for relationships between lenders and mortgage holders would be honoured. Now, I've also said yesterday here in the House that we're preparing legislation to give a legislative base to that. I have sent the heads of the bill to the central bank. I wasn't in a position to discuss the heads yesterday here in the House because they haven't been legally proofed yet by the Attorney General's office. But I intend to have an ongoing dialogue in the Finance Committee, and I will report progress on putting the statutory base under the formal commitments that have been given by the loan book purchasers.
Thank you. Deputy Donnelly, 1 minute. Thank you.
Thank you, Minister. You see, the problem with all that is you wrote the legislation. You wrote the legislation that has determined all of this. You wrote the legislation and forced through the legislation here late at night that said, well, we're not going to consider the interests of the citizens. You've just said in reply to Deputy Doherty that you don't want to send out a signal to the international markets, who this government appears to be enthralled to, that there's anything wrong here. Yet you've no issue with not sending out a signal to the Irish citizens who elected you and who you were meant to be looking after. You see, your position seems to be, sure, let's hope everything works out. Let's hope that they voluntarily comply. But the policy is all about choice. Then these are the choices you've made. Don't consider the interests of the mortgage holders. Don't provide the PwC report to the Dáil. Don't ask the debt firms for binding commitments. Don't provide oversight for how they behave. Don't legislate to ensure they do behave. Don't let families bid on their own mortgages. And shroud everything in secrecy. Now, this is what we got from the special liquidator. And, Minister, we've managed to actually get a few pages where there are words on them. But most pages, I'm sad to say, look like that. Big black square.
We're not entitled to display documents.
Sorry, Ken Corley. But what they didn't redact was the criteria that were used based on your legislation. The criteria, size of the loans, timing constraints, likely credible interest, risks associated with execution of the model, level of interest of the sectoral sector, estimated equity value, performance of the underlying business.
Thank you.
They're the criteria that were used. Nowhere in there, in all those wide criteria, nowhere in there has crept in the interests of the tens of thousands of men, women and children involved. So my question to you is, why, as Minister for Finance, do you stand over a process that was able to consider lots and lots of different criteria, but somehow wasn't able to consider the interests of Irish citizens?
Thank you. Minister.
The Deputy's very strong advocacy illustrates one of the main problems with the approach taken by the generality of the opposition to all these and related matters. Nobody stands up for the taxpayer anymore. Everybody stands up for the individual who has a difficulty. And the proposition always being put is that the individual who has a difficulty must be relieved by taking funds from the generality of taxpayers to relieve it. That's the position. It's been the position widely advocated on mortgage relief as well. And the job of the liquidator is to ensure that he gets the best possible price for assets so that the taxpayers isn't asked to contribute more to fill some kind of black hole if the liquidation doesn't produce full value. That's the position. Now, I know it's a lot easier to present the individual case, but there's a general case as well, which I'm obliged under law to protect, and that's the protection of the generality of taxpayers, so that they don't get another bill. And that's the nub of the position, and all the advocacy in the world won't remove that. Now, the liquidator was independent in the exercise of his functions. The people who participated in the debate when we brought in the legislation were very anxious, and rightly so, that there would be no political interference with the liquidator. And the liquidator is carrying out his mandate in accordance with law. But it's also true to say no single mortgage holder is worse off because Lone Star or Oak Tree has his mortgage than he was when his mortgage was inside an IBRC. He's no worse off. But you're making a case that he should be better off and that the taxpayer should pay for it. That's the case you're making.
That completes the leader's questions for today.